I'm at least at back reporting.
Kelly, is there any way, because these two guys can box when they want to, that this fight doesn't turn into the kind of exchanges and war throughout that people want?
I think it's eventually going to. It may not. I think it is. Again, they get a little tired at the end of the fight. And when you get tired, you don't have the energy to box. You usually sit down in the pocket, start putting your turn, your hips and everything into it, and try to land what you can. Hopefully you hurt somebody. I think towards the end of the fight, the latter rounds, I see that happen.
Who wins the fight? Who is your final prediction?
It would be a good fight. Listen, I'm in the media now, and I got my own show. I got to look good when I make these predictions, right? So you got to know when to hold them, when to fold them. I'm not making a prediction. I'm going to sit back as a big boxing fan and watch this fight unfold. Again, I say I'm leaning towards Canelo, so that way if Canelo wins, I'm like, man, I told you guys. I should have looked my instinct on that. But I can't give you a win.
Rico versus Loma, who you lean towards in that one?
I go with Lomachenko, one reason, size. Or to take that back, maybe two reasons. Size and the way he fights. Rigo, to me, they both are almost identical in the moves they make when they're boxing, okay, how they fight. Rigo, to me, is more of a boxer. Like I'm talking about, he moves more on the feet, and then he hits you, but he has great power, too. As with Lomachenko, actually has a lot of power, and he only does it when he wants to in fights, and you can hear it. But Lomachenko's more in your chest too, though. You know, he gets in there and he throws a lot of punches and he tries to take you out while making good moves. I think the reason why I take Lomachenko is that with his size, and if he brings the fight to Brigandel like he does, if is the aggressor in that fight, I think he could squeak out a decision in that. It's a very tactical fight, honestly.